So I'm here with Graham Cushway, the Brexit Party candidate for Brighton Kemptown and Peacehaven. Welcome back to Latest News, Graham. Tess, how's it going on the campaign trail?
The campaign trail is going very well, thanks, Mark. We've had really good reception, particularly up in places like Peacehaven, who you've got a lot of things to be... People up there have got a lot of things to be angry about, obviously, and they're not happy at all. And they'd rather see a change in a country that wants to change politics for good. As such, yeah. Seeing a lot of people switching over to or returning to the Brexit Party. And we're looking forward to a relatively good result in those areas. As I was saying before the interview, we also had a go at leafleting the Amex Stadium and we had a lively reception with lots of friends and some people who were not as friendly, but that's fine. We've also had our battle wagon down, making a lot of noise, going up and down the streets. Again, that's had a mixed reception. A lot of people were very happy to see it.
That was on the Brighton seafront,
wasn't it? It was for a little while, and then it progressed up and down the towns. The battle wagon's coming back, so you can look forward to seeing that in action again.
And so, what's it been like on a doorstep? Because it's a bit mixed. Your constituency, I would say. Is Kemptown's very much Remain, I would say, but is Peacehaven more Leave, is that right? Or is it mixed?
As a whole, the constituency voted 43% to Leave, so obviously it's a majority of Remainers. Yeah. But most of those are, as you say, focused in the middle of Brighton Kemptown. When we go up to Peacehaven, Little Haven, Rottingdean, parts of Bevingdean as well, Saltdean and places like that, we're finding it's very strongly Leave.
So is it going to be a Brexit election or not? What's your feeling on the doorstep at the moment?
Well, for us, it absolutely is a Brexit election. I mean, Brexit's the defining issue of our day. This is the most important political question we've been asked in, well, probably forever. Or possibly since 1973, but that wasn't properly explained, of course, at the time. So what we're finding is people are still talking about it a great deal. The first thing people talk about is whether we're being taken out or not. So they'll talk about Boris's deal or whatever it is. And then it goes on to other things. But a lot of the other things are a knock-on effect of Brexit anyway. Like, for instance, people talk about hospital waiting times and things like that. Well, the reason that hospital waiting times are very long are obviously because there's an awful lot of people in the place. And the reason there's a lot of people is because of freedom of movement. And that's because of the EU. Mm. So a lot of these problems are actually EU-related in any case, and everything sort of revolves around Brexit at the end of the day. It's such a fundamental question. And once we've solved that question, then we can go on and start talking about all the other things as well.
So, with the Conservatives, do you think they've kind of... The polls have gone slightly down for the Brexit Party. Have you've got a theory about that, haven't you, in terms of what's happened with the Conservatives? Have they made inroads, do you think, with the Brexit Party?
Well, absolutely. And the reason that they made inroads was, of course, that we had to stand down half of our candidates. However, I do not believe that was a voluntary decision, and I don't think it was a tactical decision. And the reason I don't think that is because I had a conversation with Joe Miller, the Tory candidate, right back in the 10th of October or something. And his primary concern then was to find out whether I would stand as an independent if I wasn't going to stand for the Brexit Party. And at the time, I thought, how ridiculous. I went back and reported it to everybody else, and we all had a good laugh. But, of course, that just shows there was some kind of Tory plot, I believe some kind of duress that's been put on us, and as a result we've had to stand down all of these candidates, and it's been a big blow to our credibility, because our main argument, of course, is that Boris's deal is not taking us out of the EU. If we then turn around and support Boris's deal, or give them half a chance, as we've been told we're doing, that undermines one of our central arguments. However, I still firmly believe that Boris's deal is not taking us out of the EU, and so do the rest of the candidates. And only standing against Labour as well makes us look like we're mini-Tories, which we're not. We're nothing to do with the Tories, which is something that they have trouble understanding.
Yeah.
So, yeah, it's hit our credibility a bit, but we're building back up. We are climbing back up in the polls.
Yeah. Just before we go, the hustings, you taking part in the hustings?
I've got three hustings this week.
Yeah.
Molscombe School. And we talked about Molscombe School last time. I think that the parents are right. I don't think that Joe Miller is right on this subject, because if you look at our contract, you'll find that what we say is that all these things should be democratically accountable. The local authority shouldn't be foisting an academy on the parents if they don't want it.
So that's Molscombe.
Yeah, I'm doing the Faith Hustings as well.
Yeah, Faith Hustings as well.
Which is going to be very interesting.
Yes.
I'm looking forward to talking about religion and faith and stuff. And I'm doing the LGBT one as well.
Yeah.
This week.
Perfect. OK, we'll look forward to that. Maybe come back for Election Day as well. So all the best for the campaign.
Thank you very much.
So far, Graham, all the best for the hustings, and we'll catch up again soon.
Superb. Thank you very much for having me on, Mark.
Thanks.
Cheers.